to the Sales Influence Podcast, where we talk about finding the why in how people buy. I'm your host, Victor Antonio. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for lending me your ears. Today, I want to talk about the discovery phase of any sales process. The discovery phase is basically where we're going to talk to the clients to qualify them and see whether or not it is a good fit for our demonstration. So for example, if you want to actually demo a product, how do we know we're talking to the right client? So now let's kind of go slowly through this. This is going to be a little longer podcast for you, but it'll be worth your time. The first phase is to really go to the qualifying process. Now, we got to ask ourselves three questions. First, we got to qualify the opportunity. Is this an opportunity? Two, we have to qualify the need. Three, we have to qualify the timing or the sense of urgency. Now, the first one, qualifying the opportunity, is this client a fit for our product or service? Good question. Number two, if it is a fit, do we qualify with them in terms of needs? Do we align with their needs? In other words, they have certain needs, and does our product or service align with that? So that is a true feature function fit, if I may say it that way. So the first one, qualify the opportunity. Is this my type of client? Two, does the product or service align with what they need? And the third part, which is qualified timing, is when are they going to make the decision? Are we talking now? Are we talking a month from now? Are we talking a year from now? What is their sense of urgency? So this is something that should be in your discovery phase. Once we kind of know that they are a fit, they're looking to make a decision, and we have the features and functionality to kind of line up with them to make sure we can offer what they want, then we got to take a step back. We got to ask ourselves a question, if not three questions. What are they currently using? What are they currently doing? And there's only three things they could be doing. One, nothing. Means they're not doing anything. Number two, they probably have some do-it-yourself approach. That's another approach. Or three, they're using the competition. Now, knowing what state they're in, nothing, do-it-yourself, or using a competitor gives us an idea of how we can position our demo when we talk to them. For example, if they're doing nothing, that means maybe we have to create not only the awareness, but also the need. Now, if they're doing something, but they're doing it in-house, that means they're doing it probably on the cheap. Maybe they've realized that they've hit a wall with their production or with their service or with their capabilities, which is why they're talking to you. Number three, if they're talking to their competitors, they're using rather their competitor, then now we know that we have to differentiate our product. We know that they have a need. We know that they care because they're using the competitor's product. So maybe they're talking to us because they're looking for some new features. So that means in this case, we'll have to differentiate what we have to offer. Now, the next set of questions you have to ask, it's really one big question, but we have to figure out what's driving them. What triggers them to want to change? Whether they're doing nothing, doing it yourself, or using a competitor, they're coming to you. That means they've been triggered to change. So what triggered them? It could be change of leadership, change of ownership. Person who owns that department, that division, now owns the actual process, right? So maybe that's change. Maybe the vendor, the competitor, has gone out of business, or maybe their product is no longer supported. That could be another one. Well, maybe they've realized that the product they're using is just too cumbersome, or maybe they need something very specific that your product or service offers. By understanding this, really, this is the holistic approach to the discovery phase. Having answers to all of the above will allow you to give a more focused demo that'll lock in with your customer. Because if I understand, yes, I've qualified you, I'm talking to the right client, they're a fit, they want the features we have, and there's a sense of urgency. And if I know what they're currently doing in terms of, are they doing nothing? Are they using some in-house brew, or are they using a competitor, will allow me to tailor the presentation. Lastly, if I know what's motivating them, what's the trigger, then I really can hone in on how to do an effective demo. And that is it for this Sales Influence Podcast. Give me some feedback on iTunes, Stitcher, YouTube, Pandora, Spotify, wherever you listen or see this. Love to get your feedback. And if you haven't checked out the Sales Velocity Academy, why haven't you? If you want to sell more faster, check out the SalesVelocityAcademy.com. Over 500 videos right now. We've just added some new fast courses if you don't have the time to sit through a whole one-hour course. So again, these fast classes are designed to get you up and running quickly. Check them out at salesvelocityacademy.com. And on that note, this is Victor Antonio always reminding you, selling ain't hard when you know how. Take care. Hi, I'm Victor Antonio. I'm an author, sales trainer, and keynote speaker. I'm often asked, what makes a great speaker? Is it someone who delivers real content that the audience can use? Is it someone who engages the audience so they're part of the learning experience? Or is it someone who can motivate an audience to push them beyond their comfort zone and discover new abilities? The answer is yes. But the most important thing to remember is that I'm not there to look good. I'm there to make my client look good. Simply put, it's never about me, and it's always about them.